The Indianapolis Colts have not been doing much in free agency, but oh, they did something on Thursday. Justin Houston, the former chief, the latest member of the Colts, reportedly a two-year, $24 million contract, a guy who was cut by the Chiefs because he was due to make a lot of money, a guy who has made a lot of money, and now he's going to be making a lot of quarterbacks in the AFC South miserable this year. The Colts, just a sneaky great team, Peter. What they did last year with Chris Bowden and Frank Reich and a healthy Andrew Luck. And I look at the AFC generally, top to bottom. I mean, there are a couple of teams that stand out for how bad they are, like the Dolphins and maybe the Bengals, but there are some star teams, and we're seeing, you know, talent moving from the NFC to the AFC, Odell Beckham Jr., Nick Foles. Now we're seeing a guy who gets cut in Justin Houston, who stays in the AFC. This conference just feels like it is far superior to the NFC, and it's going to be difficult to get to the playoffs and get through the playoffs in 2019 for all of these teams.
You know, Mike, I think the reason why the Chiefs did this is that they basically wanted to make a clean break, and I think that Andy Reid wants to say to Brett Veach, okay, it's time to build a new team. It just is. Dee Ford, Tom Bahaly, Justin Houston, Eric Berry. It's time. You can't, you know, jerseys that people have been wearing to the stadium for 4, 5, 6 years, you know, that might work in baseball. If you're in Seattle and you wear Ichiro's jersey for 10 years. But in football, other than with quarterbacks, it really rarely works. And Justin Houston has missed 16 games in the last 3 years. He's had 22 and a half sacks in the last 3 years. He's been a good player and an injured player in the last 3 years. And he still could be excellent. Still could be, because he flashes on the edge sometimes and he still looks fantastic. But that's few and far between. And now, when a guy's 30 years old, it's just time for the Chiefs to move on. And it's a good risk for a cap-rich team to take. An excellent signing by Chris Ballard, but I've got zero problem with the Kansas City Chiefs letting Justin Houston walk.
You know, I thought teams that had quarterbacks on these large second contracts are supposed to have cap problems. The Chiefs are the ones with the cap problems, and they haven't paid Patrick Mahomes yet. And you got the Colts sitting on nine figures, not anymore. But it's just amazing to see what the Colts have been able to do, and to have such a great team filled with young guys who are contributing at low salaries. At some point, you got to pay those guys. That's why the Chiefs did what they did, though. They see what's coming with Patrick Mahomes. They've got to shed some of these big salaries, or they're not going to be able to pull it off, Peter.
And the Colts basically said, when Chris Ballard came in, he saw what he thought was a dearth of talent collected by Ryan Grigson. And Grigson had paid some guys, but not a lot of guys. And so what they have done is they have shed some of the contracts that Ballard didn't like. And it's the classic case of a new guy coming in and he's going to create his own team. That is what Chris Ballard's doing in Indianapolis.
Yeah, and look, that AFC South, it wasn't all that long ago that it was the worst division in football top to bottom. Now, I don't know who the favorite is. Jacksonville with Nick Foles could be dramatically better than they were last year. The Texans with Deshaun Watson, if they give him some help on the offensive line, and they're trying to. The Colts were great last year. They made it to the playoffs. The Titans, I guess, are the one team that will kind of stand out, because I don't know what they have at quarterback. I'm not sure that they know what they have at quarterback, but they've got Mike Vrabel as a head coach, and he's good for 3 or 4 wins on his own. I see any of these teams potentially winning that division, and maybe we're going to have a Super Bowl representative come out of the AFC South sooner rather than later, Peter.
Mike, I don't understand Leonard Fournette and the Jaguars, especially how the year ended. You've got Tom Coughlin and Doug Marrone. They just had an awful chemistry year. They got an F- in chemistry last year with Jalen Ramsey, Fournette, all these guys. Why, oh why, do you extend yourselves and make peace and bring Leonard Fournette back? I mean, don't you think, Mike, that at the first sign of crapola in mid-September, that Leonard Fournette is going to be a problem again? I mean, that's what I think. He's going to have to prove otherwise to me and to a legion of Jaguars fans. That's the one decision in the offseason in the AFC South that is weird.
Here's the key, though, Peter. They've attacked his guaranteed money for this year and next year. We haven't heard whether or not that is resolved. But if they prevail as a result of the suspension he had last year, you wipe out the remaining guarantees. You've got ultimate leverage over him. You can tell him one false move and you're out of here and you're not getting paid. And that can be very powerful for the Jaguars.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.